Hello, everybody, and welcome back to Stealwing 33 Plays Enter the Gungeon. I'm Stealwing 33, and hello, everybody. How's it going? We've been having a really, really good run of form lately, and so I'm hoping to kind of, you know, keep that going. The guns we've been getting, the play we've been making, it's been pretty good so far. Pretty good. So I'm excited to kind of get into it more. We'll take the plunger, I guess. The plunger. I actually know what that one does. It shoots poison everywhere. It's a pretty good gun, especially if you can get like the hazmat suit, or there's one that makes you just immune to poison. I don't remember what that one's called. We're playing as the pilot today. We're at the top of the order once again. Still haven't beaten the game. I got pretty close with the hunter on the last video, so if you're interested in watching that, I'd suggest going back and watching that video because it was a really good run. The last two runs have been really good. I've been really working on my ability to dodge without needing to do the dodge roll. And so some other fundamentally type stuff. Learning to aim, learning to focus on myself and the bullets at the same time. Stuff like that. So it's been alright. I still lose it every now and then. Mostly when it comes to, like, watching the bullets and where I'm aiming at the same time. Bosses like the Amokanda and the Cannonball Rog and stuff kind of give me a little bit of an issue because it's hard to watch them and watch what's going on around me at the same time. I am interested in the Molotov, actually, because the Molotov is a super, super good active item, in my opinion. I don't know if that opinion is popular or not, but I really like the Molotov because you can really bake somebody to death. There's a lot of bosses that are just directly countered by it. I almost called her the Medusi. The Gore Gun, there we go. And the Wallmonger is countered by it too, because if you put it in the right place, it sits on top of it for a little while and really cooks its own bacon. A little less countered than some of the other bosses that are countered by it. Dudes like the Trigger Twins are like super countered by it. Gatling Gull is obliterated by the Molotov if you put it in the right place. Just gotta remember to plan your cards right. I didn't even see that guy, for the record there. Whew. I'm glad it was a rubber bullet though, because, you know, that would have been bad if it was one of those like Tesla bullets, the shocker bullets or whatever from like floor 2. Because we would have got hurt. And that would have been bad. That's alright. We're doing pretty good so far. Pilot is really holding it down. Damn it. I say as I don't even notice that. Jesus Christ. As I don't even notice that, bandana bulletkin. But that's okay. We took two shots on this floor. Again, the first floor has a tendency to kind of be more forgiving with HP if you're really, you know, lucky, I guess, is the right word for it. I do want a gun that isn't the Rogue Special to go into the boss fight with. The Rogue 7, Rogue Special? I don't remember. Because I hate this gun. I hate it a lot. I think it's my least favorite gun in the game at this point. And I look forward to not having to use it any longer. Like, if we get in with, like, the crossbow or the regular shotgun would be good. I'd take the sawed-off. We proved that the sawed-off is not a bad gun. Just a little it's a little high-risk, high-reward kind of stuff going on there, but nothing wrong with that. We're going to open it up because I want another gun. The lowercase r is not what I wanted, but it is better than the Rogue Special. It's just a little bit more annoying than the Rogue Special. It does less damage, but at least the bullets go where I want them to go, rather than, like, sort of not at all where I want them to go. So, you know, that's the position that we're in. Probably would have been worth my time to have used a lockpick on the brown chest instead of using my actual key on it, but, you know, what am I going to do? Lodestone Man. The Elder Blank is good, the armor is good, but we're going to have to ignore all of that, because none of it is really worth the time. The amulet is pretty good, because you know, having your blanks get augmented is not bad. It's not bad at all. You know, it's the kind of thing that you don't think it's going to be good, and then it's good. It's kind of like a fried Twinkie. You know, it's the kind of thing that you're like, I don't know if I'm going to enjoy that, and then you eat one, and you're like, hot damn, Fried Twinkie, man. Fried Twinkie hype. Is there anything left for us to do on this floor? No. Is there anything for us to buy in the shop that I might be interested in? The Molotov. Or let's buy the Molotov. I'd rather have it than not have it. And I would like to have an active item that isn't the lockpick. It sounds nice. Who do we got? Trigger Twins, I think? Yeah, Trigger Twins. So it's a good thing I bought this thing, because now I can just come in here and do this. Burn them all both to death real good. Burn them real good. Real good. The lowercase r has, like, the longest reload time ever. And it doesn't do very good damage, but it does have a ridiculous amount of ammo. And it's kind of a funny... It's like a funny weapon, you know? One of those, like, cheeky, weird weapons that you don't think is going to be good, and then it isn't good, but it, you know, says bullet over and over again. And you're like, wow, I can't believe I ever got this. This is the worst thing ever. Like, I think I'm actually better off using the Rogue Special. These guys are big enough where it's going to be hard for me to miss. And I think that that's, you know, a good place to be in, realistically speaking. Let's go ahead and burn up the other Trigger Twin a little bit here. I don't know if they actually get healed or not, or if their health bar just takes over, like, the remainder of the health bar after one of them dies. But in the event that they do retain their health bar, it's kind of in your favor to weaken the... They're like a WoW boss, right? So you can spend a little bit of extra time weakening them both down. And that will do it. Alright, cool. Yeah, so they do get healed, so it is not worth your time to do that at all. In fact, focusing one of them down is now infinitely more worth your time because, you know, it's kind of important. I do think killing Smiley first is better than killing Shades first because Shades' shots are easier to dodge than Smiley's because Smiley does, like, the crazy machine gun attack, and that thing is annoying. Okay, cool. We're still good. We're still good. We're still in mastery territory. We haven't gotten hit yet. Got him. All right. Knocked his teeth out, apparently. Knocked his smile out. Alright. Not bad. What the hell is this? Cluster mine, huh? Alright, let's get rid of the trusty lockpick, because it is Garbo! And we will take cluster mines and the Molotov with us. Lowercase r proving once again to be the worst gun in the game. Rogue Special, still bad! I still really don't like the Rogue Special, but, you know, it does do pretty decent damage. I mean, it does infinity ammo weapon damage, which is not terrible. Ow. Okay, well, that sucks. We lost our armor. But that's okay. We're fine for right now. Bullet gun is good against, like, rooms of dudes, because it has, like, really good knockback, and it has, like, it causes hit stun on the person when you hit them with it. If you don't know what I mean by hit stun, if you watch the bulletkin, when I hit them with it, they can't fire. It doesn't work on all the enemies, as we're discovering right now. So, you know, it makes it slightly worse, but that being said, you know, if it works against the bulletkin, it makes them not able to shoot at me super good. I think that that's something we can really get invested in here. You can kind of see, so, like, when I shoot the guy, he sort of, like, rebounds a little bit. It makes it harder for him to shoot me. You saw with the sniper guy, I think. You know, that being said, it is the kind of thing that I'm not 100% on. I'm surprised that worked out. Normally, when I try to do cheeky stuff like that, it gets me blown up. But it didn't this time. These hollow points are the enemy that we need to kill for our hunting mission, which I don't know what we get on this one. You know, I'm hoping it's something good. I haven't actually gotten the elephant gun yet. And I don't remember what we unlocked on the first time we did one of the hunting missions, but... I think there was something good. I know the hunting missions are normally pretty lucrative. Like, they take a while, but the thing you get out of it is pretty good. From what I remember. Just kick this over there. Blow that guy up. Kill this dude right here. Oop, ow, well, okay. That's BS, but fine. I guess that's fine. Alright, we're good. Kill this guy. Feeling good. You know, this is going pretty well. We're taking a little bit of dumb damage here and there, but nothing insurmountable, you know? We've definitely walked into harder floors with less and succeeded. Are you... You're not a... Okay, good. what is this, the M1911? It's an alright gun. It's about as good as the Rogue Special, but it's more accurate, which is nice. The Ballad, I don't know what the Ballad does, so we're going to ignore it. I might come back for the Book of Chest Anatomy, because I don't know what it does, but we unlocked it for shooting a mimic, so I'm kind of hoping that it's like... I'm hoping it's something that like lets us know it's in a chest or something before we open it. That might be cool. Or something that lets us heal by interacting with chests somehow. Either one would be pretty good, in my opinion. M1911 is an alright gun. It's not like the SAA or something like that. And it's not the Colt. The Colt 1811 or whatever the hell the one in this one is. But it's alright. It's alright. It's definitely accurate, which I think is a good case to be made for a room clearing gun. And it can fire as quickly as you click, as you can see. So, you know, stuff like that is pretty good. We're going to take the lowercase r ammo. I know the lowercase r is garbage, but it is the gun that has the least ammo. And it is nice to make sure that all of your weaponry is up to date. I want to keep everything at least above 50%, and the M1911 was not at 50%, so that's my reasoning for, you know, purchasing, getting the lowercase r ammo instead of the M1911 ammo. That, and it does translate directly into more bullets for one gun than the other, which means less than you think it does, but in my head it makes me feel better about taking the ammo for it, and that's what I'm going with. The Iron Maiden, the Lead Maiden, sorry, is annoying, but you know, I've learned how to not get hit by her, I think, without having to really do too much dodge rolling. Let's go back to the shop. I want to see if there's any keys in here. There is indeed a key. We're not going to be getting the Prime Primer. I'm not focusing on getting the parts to the bullet for right now. Mostly because they're... Getting them puts you at a disadvantage, and I'm not able to beat the game with all cylinders firing yet. So it feels bad to sort of spend, you know, time and money on stuff when I can't even do it the normal way, let alone trying to make myself, like, hinder myself. Because buying the Prime Primer means you can't buy anything for, like, two or three floors, which can be a really big detriment, especially for, like, key economy and stuff. Which, you know, matters less in the long run, ow, than, like, say, having to take a flying item down, which can put you at a disadvantage because then you don't have any actives, right? So then you're getting hit by bosses, you're not getting mastery points, etc., etc. It can get kind of nasty. The bullet gun is still terrible. Every time I use it, I'm reminded of how terrible it is, and that hurts me a little. Let's just use the Rogue Special for right now. We'll save the rest of our M1911 bullets for the boss fight. The M1911 is not a boss-killing gun, but it's more accurate than the Rogue Special. I do have two actives. I got Cluster Mines and the Molotov. We're probably going to make judicious use of those for the boss fight. The stopping power on this gun is pretty good. I'll give it that much. And it's pretty good at clearing out, like, crowds of enemies. You know what this would be good for? Is if we make it down to the fourth floor, and there are those rooms with, like, all the skeletal bullet men on them, that'll be really good against those guys. Like, the little, like, munchkin-looking dudes. Whose names I don't actually know. But they come in swarms. You know what I'm talking about. This gun will actually be pretty good against them. Let's just make sure this isn't a mimic. It is not. Alright. Hazmat suit. Nice. Hazmat suit, pretty good, actually. Definitely had worse guns before. Did we check the other treasure room for stuff? I don't remember. I mean, if we didn't, it's too late now, so we'll just leave. No, the shop didn't have any guns on it, or I would have bought them. Alright, Amoconda, huh? Right, let's see. I don't know actually what this thing does, so it throws out a bunch of grenades. I got hit already, so no use stressing about getting killed here, or getting hit here anymore. Which kind of sucks, but it's because I was checking to see what the hell that gun did. Oh, well, okay. Well, taking bits of damage here. I don't know if we're gonna make it much further in this run here, because we're kind of taking a lot of damage, and we didn't get anything remotely good to use against anything. We're sort of just stuck with, like, the bullet gun and shit, which, you know, take it or leave it, this gun is pretty bad. And then the M1911 was not a good get against, like, it would have been a good get if we had gotten something to, like, really help us deal with the boss fights and stuff, but we didn't, so... I don't know if the, what's it called? The cluster launcher is very good. Does pretty decent damage, but, like, I don't know. You know what it'd be good against? It's, like, the kill pillars. It'd be pretty good against them. Be garbo against pretty much everything else in the fucking game, though, because... Ooh! Well, there we go. We're dead. Well, You know, I think that's gonna do it for this episode. There'll be a second Gungeon episode today, because this one's coming up a little short. It was long enough where I don't think... that's not what I want to do. I want to return to the breach. It was long enough where I think doing a second run would be folly at this point. But next episode would be doing the Marine. I'm sorry that we're back to just doing more Gungeon videos. I'm really busy with work, and I don't really have, like, a hell of a lot of time to devote to, you know, making other content. Like, I don't have the hour and a half that I normally do to, like, record videos and things. So, you know, we're kind of stuck doing Gungeon for right now, because I can bang out a Gungeon run in, like, 40 minutes when I need to take a break from working and staring at my computer screen. Which is nice. So, I think on that note, we're gonna call it quits for this episode. So thank you all so much for watching. If you like what you saw, let me know. If you want to see more, don't forget to subscribe to the channel to keep up to date on when I post more videos. I am planning on doing a Dark Souls series, next week. I finally beat Dark Souls on the PS4. And so I'm feeling okay enough to, like, really sit down and try to beat the game again, on the channels, because I'm not gonna die 50 or 60 times against, like, you know, some of the later game bosses. I can actually, like, you know, feel good about myself doing it. So on that note, again, thank you all so much for watching. I'll catch you guys in the next video. Bye!